Behold, I stand at the door and knocking at the door. If anyone opens the door for him, for me, I will enter into your house and I will stay with you. So you should hunger for him and you should invite him into your life. You should invite him into your heart. Heart also symbolizes something else. What is that? Take the book of Proverbs, chapter 4, verse 13 onwards. The heart is the place which take decisions in life. So the Lord is saying now, I want to be in your heart. Means when you take decisions, you have to invite the Holy Spirit. You have to consult the Holy Spirit. When you want to do something, when you want to go somewhere else, whatever may be your reason, you need to make him a companion. You need to make him a partner. You need to make him a decision maker. You need to make him a lover. Yes. If you keep him in your heart and invite him in every decision of yours, you will find him growing in you day by day. So love him. Love him with your whole heart. That's why we read in the book of Proverbs, chapter 8, verse 37, those who love me will be loved by me. Those who seek me will be found by me. Yes. If you seek him, if you understand the truth, for me, today, in this world, I am easily being broken. I am easily being led by temptation. I am easily destroyed because I am not receiving the companion which Jesus has given to me. Instead of living with that companion, instead of hungering for the companion, instead of consulting with that companion, instead of loving that companion, when I leave, I consult ABCD. I consult the world. I consult the worldly people. I consult my experience. I consult what are the books I have read. I have consulted the people, Kalraner said, R.I. said, some theologians said. They are all human beings. They have walked with God. They have sincerely given their experiences. But an experience of an individual is different from God himself. Amen. God may give me riches and I can thank him. I may have riches or I may not have riches. Yesterday I didn't have rich. I didn't have money. So I called upon the Lord. Today I have the riches. But still I will call upon the Lord. Because money is money. Yesterday it was not there. Today it is there. Tomorrow it may be there or may not be there. But there is someone who will be with me. In my misery, he was there. Today in my fullness, he is there. Tomorrow when everything goes away, he will be with me.
Amen.
Money is money. God is my God.
Amen.
Don't lose sight of your root. Don't lose sight of who you are, who is your God? Who is this companion God has given to you? You have to treasure him in your heart. You can't afford to lose him. You can't afford to lose him. Some people, they love their parents. I know of a girl. She told me, I will give my life for my mother. She went to USA and then she wrote a letter. I have found a companion. And I want to marry him. The mother said, we have grown in faith and you want to leave our faith, leave Jesus and want to get married to another guy. No, that is not right. That is not right. You do take any guy I accept, but not the guy who doesn't lead you to God, to our living God. Don't bring anything in the place of our living God. Don't lose him. Don't throw away your life for nothing. Don't throw away your God. She did not listen. The same girl who said, for my mother I will give my life. When somebody came, she was just changed. She never even came. After 7 years she came with the 2 children as a woman who have no husband. What happened? The man whom he married, he left her. Because of the marriage, she lost the job. She became so fat. She became sick with a miserable situation. She didn't have a girl who was educated by her father, MCA. And she was studying MBA. Today, she didn't have even money to buy milk for her baby. Her companions, they gave some money, bought the tickets and sent her back to Hyderabad. The girl said, Daddy, please come, forgive me. Mummy, please forgive me. If you don't come, I will be stranded in the airport, for I don't have even a single dollar. The daddy cried. I made $20,000 and I send you. You lost your God. And today, even though you have education, even though you went to a country full of money, they say, today you are returning even without a dollar. The enemy will enter into your life and take away everything God has given to you. Don't afford to lose him. That's why you need the Holy Spirit. It is he who will give you the wisdom. That's why we read in the book of Isaiah, chapter 30, verse 20 onwards. When you wait on him, when you call upon him, you will hear the voice telling you, my son, this is the way. My daughter, this is the way. Yes. Some people even commit their life for God. Suddenly one guy talks nicely, one girl talks to you nicely, they forget everything. They become mad. Yes. They even leave their religious life and end up with a little world, with their little family. Yes. I know of a companion. He was a very good man. Very good theology. He got first mark in theology. But when he was working, he got a project, a so huge project. Suddenly love for money came into him. And the habit of drinking alcohol came into his life. That brought all the vices. One day he realized, I've got enough and more money. What will I do? Let me get married and be happy. That is the end of his life. The joy, the peace went away. His inner conscience began to prick. That money you are using is not yours. That money belongs to God. You are bringing your body is God's temple. You are destroying God's temple. And the evil spirit will come through alcohol. He became mad. When he became mad, the wife, the beautiful wife, he told me one day, she's an American lady. I married a foreign lady. She's mad after me. And my children are looking like Americans. Today, they all left him because he became mad. He was jailed in the USA. Became mad. He was jumping into a house. The dog bit him. And the owners came, put him into the jail, into the police custody. Hello. Take care of your precious life. Take care of your soul. And only in the companionship of the Holy Spirit, your life is safe. You have to hunger for Him. You have to learn to love Him. If you don't love Him, the love of the world will replace your heart.